North Shore High School Key Club located in Glenhead, New York. And our goal today is to inform you about the dangers of vaping and why saying no is so important. Okay, so first of all, can everyone raise their hand if you know what a Juul is or if you've ever heard of a Juul? Thank you. Keep your hand raised if you know someone that Juuls. Okay, you can put your hands down. So as you can see, this is a pressing issue that needs to be addressed immediately, and it's becoming more and more popular, and more people are becoming aware that Juuls are harming our communities. Yes?
How about you? Do you know someone that Juuls?
I do. I actually know some people at my school and some older people that graduated from our school or that are just part of our community. So we're going to tell you why today it's so important to say no. Okay, so someone who kept their hand raised, can you answer why do you think people Juul? Why do you think people Juul?
People Juul because they think that it's cool.
Yeah, that's true. That's actually the number one reason. So the number one reason, as I said, is because people think that it's a cool social thing to Juul and that their friends do it. That they think that they'll gain some sort of social acceptance if they engage in this behavior. Number two is that people claim it's not as bad as cigarettes, but we have evidence showing that it truly is. Three, the wide flavor variety. There's mango, mint, blueberry, all these intriguing flavors to young adults. And four, the buzz. The buzz that it would give you, the type of feeling that it gives off when you use these vapes. So this past year alone, 56% of youths and young adults that ever used an e-cigarette or Juuls were reported that they were younger than 18. So that is our audience here. You guys are either 18 or younger than 18. So this is just showing that this relates to you.
So Juuls are being abused and used. So the company Juul wasn't initially targeted towards teenagers. Their mission statement was to improve the lives of the world's 1 billion adult smokers by driving innovation to eliminate cigarettes. So initially Juul wanted to target its products towards cigarette users as a healthy alternative. So that's not really what happened. Teens started using Juuls, as we've seen in recent years. And you might be asking yourself, why is Juuling so dangerous? Does anybody want to try to answer that?
Because it can be bad for your lungs.
That's a good point. It can be bad for your lungs.
Okay, so due to the fact that Juuling has been very new and recently used product, the long-term effects are unknown. However, recently we have been noticing many cases where Juuling has been impacting many people using it. Does anyone know what the main ingredient in a Juul is?
Nicotine?
Yes, nicotine is the highly addictive drug that gets the person who's using the Juul to catch a feeling of wanting to use it more and more. But it's not only the feeling that they're addicted to, it's what's making them go back to the Juul over and over again. As you can see, there have been many cases that have proven that people have been impacted by Juuling. There have been 28 deaths in every state but Alaska, and it's just getting worse and worse.
So let's talk about what a Juul is and what its purpose is. They're foam electronic cigarettes that were created for an alternative use for smoking. But the company never intended for young kids to use them, especially at the rate they're doing now. Yeah.
How long have Juuls been around?
Not long. They were invented during our lifetime, which makes them even more dangerous because no long-term study has been done to prove how dangerous they are. So what we do know about Juuling is that it's really dangerous for you. And this picture of a young girl who suffered from a vaping related incident shows how powerful their message can be. Right, and 10.7 million kids aged 12 to 17 have either used or would use an e-cigarette.
So like we said before, why people use the Juul is because they think it's a better alternative to cigarettes. but it's really not at all, because as you see here, only one Juul pod is equivalent to a full pack. So after just 5 Juul pods, which you might think isn't that much, you're considered an established smoker who can be smoking packs and packs of cigarettes. So it's really not better in any way.
On average, do people smoke a pod faster or a pack of cigarettes?
Normally a pod, because the thing about Juuls is they don't have that strong scent, so it's more easily accessible in schools and other places. And the issue has gotten so bad that our own government is getting involved, and they're trying to ban these popular flavors. And the CEO of Juul stepped down, so in a way he's like surrendering, because there's just no fight against this.
And if Juuls are so bad, why did it take our government so long to ban the popular flavors?
So like we were saying before, we haven't really seen the long-term effects, but now we're starting to see these people getting hospitalized and even dying. So now they're taking charge.
So does anyone know what a G pen, wax pen, or dab pen is? You can raise your hand if you do, or if you've heard of one. Okay. So I'm here to tell you about the difference between them. So a vape pen typically has liquid forms of THC or other vape liquids, while a dab pen typically has solid forms. Okay, so here's an image of a pen that might contain THC or another vape. Yeah, so what was your question?
Do you know any of the impacts that these vape pens have?
Yeah, so the picture before was actually showing someone who had a pulmonary-related vape illness from one of these vape pens with THC in it. Daily smokers can experience an IQ drop up to 8 points, so that's one impact. It also influences your heart, your blood, and your blood pressure. So yeah. Although it lets someone have like a low profile because it doesn't give off that odor, as Juliet was saying, similar to the Juuls, people are still using it and it's becoming more easily accessible. So how is smoking out of a pen so dangerous?
Yeah, you might not know what's in it.
Exactly. While you think you're just buying the liquid that you put into the pen, you don't actually know the contents in that liquid. Okay, so THC is the active ingredient in weed, and like I was saying before, you don't know exactly what is in
especially because it's illegal, so it's not regulated by the government. So you don't really know what you're getting when you buy it.
And these long-term effects are unknown because we are like the guinea pig generation that is just presented with these now. And as we know, like smoking out of cigarettes is very harmful for your health and can cause lung cancer and all these other diseases, but we just don't know the long-term effects yet.
So you might be asking yourself, how does this affect me? So raise your hand if you're a student, and keep your hand raised if you're an athlete too. All right, so this does affect you. So Juuls and I, we run track, and your respiratory endurance is really important for a sport like track. And if you're Juuling, then you know your long-term endurance is weakened with the nicotine addiction. And you can experience shortness of breath.
Yes, so since we're runners, it takes a lot of our oxygen and our energy to run every single day in workouts or easy runs. However, if I were to Juul or if Keaton were to Juul, we would have shortness of breath. It would be very difficult for us to really keep up with everybody on the team, especially in football or lacrosse, doing short sprints. Or even just running a lap around the field, it's very difficult.
So not only athletics does Juuling have an impact, but also school. So just the addiction to a Juul will cause lack of attention in class, which will ultimately impact your grades if you're not paying attention in class. And just beyond the obvious, there are major consequences if you're caught in school or public places with a Juul, so that can result in suspension, which is put on your transcript, and colleges see that, so that kind of stays with you. So you've got to really be careful and make good choices now.
And if you're really good student and want to get good grades juuling, this can lower your IQ points up to 8 points.
Yeah, daily smokers have experienced up to 8 points in reduction.
And also, it increases your heart rate, and that causes you to become distracted and like panicky sometimes. Any vape or Juul that contains nicotine, that can happen too.
Is it too late to do something? That's the major question that people are worried about, but the answer is no. Although it may be very difficult, it's not impossible.
It's not too late, it's never too late to stop juuling. If you or someone you know has a problem, then they can always talk to someone they trust, like an adult or a teacher, and they'll get the help they need. Yeah?
What if the person you know is really addicted?
Even then, they can always get help and fix their issue.
You can always go to a trusted adult and let them know about the problem that your friend's experiencing, or a nurse at the school, or any adult that you trust.
I know someone that actually got nicotine poisoning, and she was very ill, and then she stopped, and then she got so much better, obviously, but it really impacts you in many ways.
So what we want you guys to take away from this is that juuling is not cool, and no matter what people say, it's never worth it to harm your body this way. You're not going to be judged better if you do vape, and if you're surrounded by people who do, then you shouldn't be around those people. And the best person you can be is yourself.
Okay, so thank you so much for having us here today. We hope that you can take away some valuable information and that you can spread this to your friends, your peers, your communities. Please like this video and share it with anyone that you might know. We want to get the word out to as many people as we can about the dangers of juuling and vaping, and we want to reach a large